جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أناديه ويستر علي كل عورة وأنا أعصيه، ويعظم النعمة علي فلا أجازيه. نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، إلها واحدا أحدا فردا صمدا قيوما، نؤمن له بالربوبية ونقر له بالعبودية. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد، كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. وصل اللهم وسلم على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والأوصياء والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وعترة نبيك وحبيبك الطيبين الطاهرين وأصحابه المنتجبين الخيرين، وعلى من يتبعهم بإحسان وإيمان إلى يوم الدين. عباد الله، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره. قال ربنا العزيز في كتابه الكريم، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: ومن آبائهم وذرياتهم وإخوانهم واجتبيناهم وهديناهم إلى صراط مستقيم، ذلك هدى الله يهدي به من يشاء من عباده ولو أشركوا لحبط عنهم ما كانوا يعملون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. The term الصراط المستقيم has been repeated throughout the Holy Quran in different chapters, and most importantly in the beginning of the Quran, Surah Al-Fatiha, and we mentioned this many times throughout the day and the night. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. What is الصراط المستقيم? And how do we get to this path, to this straight path? Where is it and how do we get to it? Definitely the Holy Quran says you get to it through following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهَ. All people, if you claim that you really love God, then the way is very easy. Follow me. Obey me and follow me. فَاتَّبِعُونِي اتِّبَاعُ يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. God is going to reciprocate this love with love and mercy. يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ. And He is going to forgive your sins for you. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Definitely we reach to الصراط المستقيم, the straight path, through having the Prophet as an example for us. مَا آتَاكُمْ وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Take what he gives you. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. When he says this is forbidden, then don't get close to that. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Historians and muhaddithin. Muhaddith is the one who narrates the hadith, speaks the hadith. It's called muhaddith, transmits the hadith from one person into another. They give him the name of muhaddith, and in the Sunni tradition, they call him al-hafidh, al-hafidh. They say that during the Hajj, the trip of Hajj of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in Masjid al-Khif. You've been to Hajj, most of you, inshallah. There is a mosque in Mina called Masjid al-Khif. In that mosque, the Prophet, while he was staying in Mina, it is required to spend two nights, at least two nights in Mina, and 2 days. The Prophet ﷺ stood and addressed his community, because this trip was only a few days before his death. This trip was in the month of Dhul-Hijjah, and the Prophet ﷺ went back to Medina, and he died at the end of the month of Safar. So it's about 70 days between this speech that he gave and his departure. He said, Ayyuhan Nas, a long, long speech, but this is what is important. Inni mukhallifun fikum al-thaqalayn. He hinted to them that I am going to leave you soon. I am going to leave you soon. The Lord informed him that I am going to leave you, but my message is not going to stop. The message of Islam is going to continue through two things. Inni mukhallifun fikum al-thaqalayn. Two thaqal or thuql. Two weighty things, two important things. وَإِنِّي مُخَلِّفٌ فِيكُمُ الثَّقَلَيْنِ الثِّقْلُ الْأَكْبَرُ. The greatest weighty things, القرآن الكريم. وَالثِّقْلُ الْأَصْغَرُ عِتْرَتِي أَهْلَ بَيْتِي. The second weighty things are my family. أَهْلُ بَيْتِي هُمَا حَبْلٌ مَمْدُودٌ. Those two things are the rope stretched from heaven to you. حَبْلٌ مَمْدُودٌ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. What is going to connect you after me? So far, I've been connecting you with Lord. I am the messenger of Allah. After my departure, what is going to connect you and your Lord are these two weighty things. حَبْلٌ مَمْدُودٌ بَيْنَكُمْ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مَا إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِ لَنْ تَضِلُّ. As long as you get hold of these two things, you are not going to be misguided or confused in your journey here on earth. Therefore, the Prophet mentions two things. And Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wasalam says, he says, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ الصَّامِتُ. This book is the book that are silent. وَأَنَا الْكِتَابُ النَّاطِقُ. And the book that is speaking book, or the spoken one, is me. There are two books. What does that mean? It means Ali is the interpreter of the Quran after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad.
Imam al-Sadiq in Kitab al-Kafi, this is a reliable book in our tradition. In Kitab al-Kafi, a person comes and asks the Imam alayhi salam about the meaning of As-Sirat al-Mustaqim. What does that mean? He says, هو الطريق إلى معرفة الله وهما صراطان صراط في الدنيا وصراط في الآخر. We have two paths, two straight paths. One of them here and the other is there. One of them here. So the journey begins here. فأما الصراط في الدنيا فهو الإمام المفترض طاعته. The sirat, the straight path in this life is the Imam that has been appointed by God, not a self-declared Imam. Today, if you Google who's the Imam, you will come up with millions of names, alhamdulillah, including my title, Imam of the Masjid. Millions of names. Those are irrelevant. The Imam that has been appointed by Allah. Allah selected him. Allah chose him. مَا كَانَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. Shura is not related to the Imam. Shura, when it comes about our affairs, related to our affairs, social life, probably political life. But when it comes to halal and haram, the Prophet never consulted any person. Did he consult the Muslims? Hey, oh Muslims, do you want the prayers to be 5 times a day or 3 times a day? Or 1 time a day? Did you hear him saying that? Did he hear the Prophet consulting, doing shura with the Muslims, with his community regarding fasting or zakat or hajj? He never asked them about these things. There is no shura in that. These are ordinances given to us by Allah, and Allah would not consult. If Allah was to consult us about the prayers, believe me, most of us, we will say once a week, not once a day. Once a week, Friday, we come Friday prayers, khalas.
Once a year.
Or probably once a year. So Allah does not consult. Consultation, wa amruhum shura baynahum, when it comes to social affairs, military rules, sometimes he would consult. He would consult. But not about halal and haram. When it comes to imama is a matter of leadership. Allah would not consult the Arabs of Mecca that, do you want me to send Muhammad or you want someone else? He never consulted them. He chose Muhammad while 99.9% of Mecca refused him. Refused him. But Allah said he is the prophet. Whether you like it or not, he's going to be the messenger. And many of them, the Quran says, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَرِهُ مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ. Many of those Arabs and the pagans. And here, it's a reference to the Muslims in this verse. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَرِهُ مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ فَأَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالَهُمْ. Some Muslims, they did not like some aspects of Islam. One of it is the imama, succession to the Prophet. Allah says, we destroyed their work. فَأَحْبَطْ حَبْطُ الْعَمَلِ. Their past work is being destroyed. Those were Muslims, companions. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses, and He knows what to choose and how to choose. مَا كَانَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. We don't leave this issue for people to decide. Therefore, صِرَاطُ الدُّنْيَا as the Imam. Imam al-Sadiq says, in this life, you have to get hold of him. Don't tell me I don't know the Imam. Go and find him. Find who's the Imam. This is your job, is to research and see who's the Imam, who's the right Imam. المفترض طاعته من عرفه في الدنيا واقتدى بهداه. If you recognize him in this life and you follow him, مر على الصراط, then you're going to get a pass over the other صراط. If you can find the صراط here, the way, the gate here, then your journey there is going to be easy. مر على الصراط. You're going to pass easily on the next صراط or the next bridge. الذي هو جسر جهنم في الآخرة. A bridge that crosses over Jahannam. If you can find your Imam here, your way, your guide, your journey there is going to be easy. You're going to pass to paradise there. ومن لم يعرفه في الدنيا. This is the problem. But if you don't want to know him, all are the same. All mu'mineen and all sahaba, mashallah, they are equal. If I say about you now, you are all equal in faith, would you accept that from me? None is going to accept. You will say, this is injustice. How do you compare me? Yes, I respect him, I like him, he's a mu'min, he's good. But he's not like me in his faith. We vary. Allah says the prophets, they vary. Prophets, messengers of God who work their entire life for God, Allah says they vary in their faith. نَرْفَعُ دَرَجَاتٍ مَنْ نَشَاءُ. We make some above others, higher than others. So if the Anbiya are not the same, you think the people are the same in their faith, in their dedication, in their devotion, in their loyalty to Allah? Definitely not. So, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَعْرِفُ فِي الدُّنْيَا زَلَّتْ قَدَمُهُ. He's going to slip there. And he's going to backslide. فَتَرَدَّى فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ. And he trembles. If you don't find your Imam here, your journey there is very difficult. It's very turbulent. The journey begins from this life. You have to prepare for the journey. Prepare the passport, the visa here before you embark on that journey. And then let me conclude with the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet says, مَا بَالُ أَقْوَامٍ. What's wrong with some people? إِذَا ذُكِرَ آلُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَآلُ عِمْرَانُ فَرِحُوا وَاسْتَبْشَرُوا. When you speak about Ibrahim and his family, they get happy, joyous. When you speak about Imran and Al Imran, which is Mary and Jesus and others, they get very happy. وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ عِنْدَهُمْ آلُ مُحَمَّدٍ اشْمَأَزَّتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. But once you mention the family of the Prophet, they become repugnant, angry, sad, depressed. اشْمَأَزَّتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. And then listen to the Prophet. وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِهِ. By the Lord who controls my soul. لَوْ أَنَّ عَبْدًا جَاءَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. If a servant of God stand before him on the day of judgment. يَعْمَلُ عَمَلَ سَبْعِينَ نَبِيًّا. He comes with his file full of work. The work of 70 messengers. The work, the righteous work of 70 messengers. مَا قُبِلَ ذَلِكَ مِنْهِ. It would not be accepted from him unless. إِلَّا حَتَّى يَلْقَ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى بِوِلَايَتِي وَوِلَايَةِ أَهْلِ بَيْتِي. His work is not going to be accepted unless he accepts and he follows my wilaya, my guardianship, my leadership of the Prophet and the leadership of my family. بولايتي وولايتي أهل بيتي. Do you want another hadith before we conclude? Another hadith. One day, Imam al-Baqir, the fifth Imam, said, إِنَّمَا يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مَنْ يَعْرِفُ اللَّهَ. The one who really worships God correctly, the one who knows God. فَأَمَّا مَنْ لَا يَعْرِفُ اللَّهِ. Someone who does not know God, really, does not know anything about monotheism. God for him is someone sitting there, you know, controlling the universe. That's it. This person does not know God. فَإِنَّمَا يَعْبُدُهُ هَكَذَا ضَلَالًا. He's going to disworship God. He thinks he's worshiping him, but he's not doing the service. He's not doing the right type of worshiping that God wants from him. How do we worship him perfectly and correctly and rightly when we know God, when we recognize him? So the person was sitting next to him, a companion of the Imam. He said to him, جُعِلْتُ فِدَاكَ فَمَا مَعْرِفَةُ اللَّهِ. Tell me, how do we recognize God? What is the way? فَقَالَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ. He answered. He said, تصديق الله. The first step in recognizing God, تصديق الله عز وجل. The approval of God, the confirmation to believe in him, to endorse him, to accept what he tells you. This is the first step. وتصديق رسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. Whatever the Prophet gives you and it brings you, you have to accept. Don't argue with the Prophet. Don't be like that man when the Prophet was on deathbed 3 days before his death. The Prophet died on Monday. On Thursday, 3 days before his death, the Prophet says, إِتُونِي بِدَوَاءٍ وَقِرْطَاسٍ. Bring me a pen and paper. Let me write a book, a will for you, that you would never be misguided. He said, leave him alone. This man is hallucinating. Hallucinating. This is exactly what is written in Sahih al-Bukhari. Sahih al-Bukhari. يَهْجُرْ. يَهْجُرْ. Hijran. Hijran, hallucination. When someone speaks of what he does not know. He says this about the Prophet. After 23 years being with the Prophet, the companion, running after the Prophet from this point to that point, now he concludes the trip by saying the Prophet is hallucinating. In another chapter of Sahih al-Bukhari, it says, لَقَدْ غَلَبَهُ الْوَجَعُ. He's overwhelmed with pain, so leave him alone. حَسْبُنَا كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. We have the book of God, the best guidance. We don't need Muhammad and what he's telling us. See? This is disbelief in the Prophet. So ma'rifatullah is the first, tasdeequllah. You accept what God tells you and you accept what Muhammad also tells you. Ma ataakum ar-rasulu fakhudhuhu wa ma nahaakum anhu fantahu. Ati'u Allah wa ati'u ar-rasul. You cannot separate between God and his messenger. You can't. Then the third step, wa muwalatu aliyyin alayhi salam, and patronage and fellowship and loyalty and standing by and adherence to Ali ibn Abi Talib, وَالْإِئْتِمَامُ بِهِ, and make him your imam, your imam, وَبِأَئِمَّةِ الْهُدَىٰ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّلَامُ. And then after him there are other successors after Ali ibn Abi Talib. وَالْبَرَاءَةُ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مِنْ عَدُوِّهِمْ. And then you become, you dissociate yourself from their enemies, the enemies of God, the enemies of the Prophet, and the enemies of Ahlul Bayt. هكذا يعرف الله عز وجل. This is the way. This is the gate. This is the road to recognize God. This is the hadith of Imam al-Sadiq. And inshallah, maybe in the future, we're going to elaborate more on hadith al-wilaya, inshallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وأهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونسبحه ونقدسه على آلائه ونعمائه ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله. اللهم صلِّ وسلم وبارك وترحم على محمد وآل محمد كأفضل ما صليت وسلمت وباركت وترحمت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وصل اللهم وسلم على خلفاء نبيك وأوصيائه وأحبته وأهل بيته علي أمير المؤمنين وقائد الغر المحجلين وعلى البضعة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين وعلى سبطي نبي الرحمة وسيدي شباب أهل الجنة الحسن والحسين عليهم السلام وعلى علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل مخرجه وجعلنا من أنصاره وأعوانه. عباد الله أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله ولزوم أمره. On Tuesday night, we hosted here at IECOC a delegation of professors and scholars of Al-Azhar University and Darul Ifta in Egypt, the office of the Mufti, and also the Wizaratul Awqaf, the Ministry of Endowment and Religious Affairs in Egypt. And I think the meeting was friendly and was fruitful and constructive. This is my opinion. And many members, the delegation were about 15 members, many of them, they told me when they were leaving here at about 11 p.m., we started about 7:20 p.m. They said, this visit here and this meeting with you changed our perception about Shia Islam. One of the professors, when they were entering and I was greeting them and shaking hand and embracing them, as I do always, he did not want to embrace me, so he puts his hand in my chest. And then he refused to pray with us here, Jama'ah. He said, I'm going to pray individual. But then when we had a meeting over dinner on that side, and he asked me about our opinion about the Sahaba, and why do we say, Ashhadu anna Ali wa Aliullah, and why this and why that? When he was leaving me, he came and he embraced me, and he said, Imam, I apologize to you. I had different idea when I came, and I am completely different now. So my perception has changed. And he kept talking and talking, and his friends were sitting in the bus and calling on him, come on, let's go, it's late. And alhamdulillah, he qarihat and fithat, mashallah. He started, you know, yeah, his appetite was so. So I think this is the reason why I always encourage these dialogues and these discussions and these visits. Of course, in the community we have two groups. One group, they don't have a positive perception of these meetings. They have a negative one, pessimistic one. They say these are fruitless. Whatever you do, you are not going to break the ice. between the two traditions and two schools. These people who degrade us, they don't recognize us, they demean us. And to a certain extent, I agree with them, to a certain extent. Because of sectarianism now, and countries who are spending billions of dollars, they have a designated budget to fight Shia Islam and to make Shia Islam look ugly in the eyes of Sunnis. They spread rumors and false accusations that they are not Muslims, they worship Muhammad al-Uraifi, one of the leaders in Saudi Arabia. The other day, just 2 days ago, it's on the CNN, you can follow it. He said the Shias, they worship the stones, they don't worship God. They worship graves, they worship their imams. And more of these allegations, and they don't believe in the Quran, they have their own Quran. I know why they say this, because Saudi Arabia and Wahhabism is the most insecure country. When it comes to madhab, when it comes to religion, it's the most insecure country. And they are losing their youth. Many of them are converting to Shia Islam, not only in Saudi Arabia, in North Africa, and they are terrified. They are terrified of this. They are terrified of what they see. However, on the other side, I know many of you have positive outlook to this dialogue, Shia-Sunni dialogue, and you encourage this, and you believe that it is fruitful. At the end, we have to reach out to others. My point, I have 2 points here. Number one, we are the followers of Ahlul Bayt. Remember, we are the followers of the Prophet and his family, his immediate family. And we must be different from others. We must be different. Not only in our aqidah, ideology and belief. We must be different in our behavior too. In our behavior, in our Islamic behavior, Islamic attitude. When we reach out to others. So don't, never, it is very wrong to compare yourself to others. Don't compare yourself to others. You are the student and the graduate of Al-Imam al-Sadiq, Al-Imam al-Baqir, Al-Imam Zainul Abidin, Al-Imam Musa ibn Ja'far, Al-Imam al-Ridha, Al-Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Fatima al-Zahra. Don't compare yourself to others. If you want to compare yourself to others, join the other side. Don't stay in this group. You have to sacrifice. You have to sacrifice and you have to follow exactly what the Quran said to the Prophet. Allah said to the Prophet, listen, Muhammad, وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّ مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. If you want to react angrily to them, to become intolerant, none is going to follow you. So you have to be tolerant. You have to accept their attacks on you. You have to accept that. You have to be strong. Don't compare yourself to others. Don't retaliate. This is number one. Remember, we are different in our akhlaq. We follow the akhlaq of Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. The second point I want to make, and I tell you this out of experience, I travel widely and I meet all the Muslims wherever I go. The vast majority of our brothers and sisters in the Sunni tradition are unaware of Shia Islam. They have been misinformed, either through their parents, family members, or some satellite TVs, or some mashayikh who are the people of Nar, Jahannam, like Al-Uraifi, and those group, Kalbani, and those group of Ahlul Nar, A'immatul Kufr, who are nurtured and paid mercenaries of the Saudi regime and the Gulf state regimes. They receive salaries, and he sells his akhirah for the king, for the mansab, for the position, for the money that he receives here. And Al-Qardawi is one of them too. So the Sunnis are misled about the Shia. Imagine, on Tuesday night, the person who asked me, he's a professor at Al-Azhar. He's not a shopkeeper, he's a professor. Teaches at the most prestigious Islamic university on earth in Cairo. And he asks me, do you have a different Quran? We hear that the Shias, they have different Quran. I said to him, guys, look at this Quran. It's printed in Medina al-Munawwar. Medina al-Munawwar, same Quran. He said, then what is Mus'haf Fatima? You say that Fatima has a book. I said, Mus'haf Fatima is a book that she compiled when she used to sit next to her father, and her father tells her a hadith and stories and the tafsir of some of the verses. And Fatima was a knowledgeable person, so she would write them down. But this book is not in public's hand. This book has only one copy, and we believe that this copy is with the 12 Imam, Al-Imam Al-Mahdi alayhi salam. So imagine if a professor who spent many years studying Sharia, not Chulu Kabab, Sharia al-Islamiyya, he studies Sharia, then he accuses you of having a different Quran. What do you say about the rest of the public? It's all about unawareness. They don't know about you. They have not met you. They have not come to your mosques. Many of them said, this is our first visit. This is our first encounter with Shia scholars. So most of them are unaware. Few of them are muta'assib, bigots. Few of them chose to follow Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Taymiyyah is a hate monger. If you read his book, Minhaj al-Sunnah, it's all Shia bashing. It's all Amir al-Mu'mineen bashing. He has animosity against Ali and Fatima. Imagine, Ibn Taymiyyah says in his book, Minhaj al-Sunnah, about Surah Al-Imran, when the Prophet took his family at the request of God, فَقُلْ تَعَالَوْ نَدْعُ أَبْنَاءَنَا وَأَبْنَاءَكُمْ وَنِسَاءَنَا وَنِسَاءَكُمْ وَأَنفُسَنَا وَأَنفُسَكُمْ. The Prophet said, God said to the Prophet, when you go in dialogue with the Christians, take Ali, Fatima, Hassan, and Hussein with you. When you go, take those with you. Ibn Taymiyyah says, if that Prophet had taken the companions with him, God would have answered him quicker and faster. Meaning the Quran is wrong. He's defying God. He's not only defying the Prophet, he's defying God. Meaning this verse is wrong. God has to change the verse. Rather than saying, قُلْ تَعَالَوْ نَدْعُ أَبْنَاءَنَا وَأَبْنَاءَكُمْ, say to them, I'm going to come with my Sahaba, with my companion. This is Ibn Taymiyyah. Some people follow him, and they love him, and they cherish him, and he's Shaykhul Islam. To them, he's the Prophet. So some of them are like that, not all of them. And here, we don't want to increase the number of the Shias, my friends. All what we have to do to defend ourselves, because this is mandatory, wajib. When you are under attack, you have to speak the truth. This is amrun bil ma'roof wa nahyun anil munkar. This is idharul haqq, ihqaqul haqqi wa ibtalul batil. To defeat the evil, you have to speak about your ideology. You cannot run away and say, I don't want to talk with this person. What good would do? Nothing will happen if you don't take it. Things are going to be worsened. So you have to open your heart and your mind and try to have a dialogue. And I think the hidayah at the end of the day, the guidance comes only by invitation. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَتْ. Those of you in this audience who are not Shia and you chose to be Shia, and there are many of you here in this audience today. Because you did something good in your life, you received the invitation. Allah does not throw like American airplanes, they go over cities and they throw, you know, pamphlets, all people do. He doesn't do that. Allah sends an invitation to your heart, special invitation, only by invitation, to get to the path of guidance. You are one of those. Maybe you did something good in your life, I don't know. Maybe your parents did, maybe your mother, maybe your grandparents. However, you did something that you deserve guidance, hidayah. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. And we always pray, inshallah, the Muslims, all schools of thought, all madhahib traditions, they get together to follow the sunnah, the correct sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to follow this book, the guidance of this book, And after the Prophet, we have to follow two, as he says, Rasulullah, Kitab Allah wa itrati ahl bayti. If you are seeking salvation, wake up, study. Most of the Muslims, they don't read. Wallahi, they don't read. 99% of the Muslim Ummah, they don't read. They don't read. And if they have time, they listen to the wrong person, not to the right person. And this is why you see generations after generations, they live in misguidance and awareness because they don't read. They don't read about religion. They don't investigate about religion. And they don't want to know. Some of them, when they discover, he says, keep me away. This is too much for me. They run away from the haqiqah, the truth. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our hearts. And you, the Shia, let me tell you, you became Shia not because you studied. 99% of you, you became Shia because you were born Shia, let me tell you. Not because you researched, huh? So don't feel proud of yourself. You must feel proud of yourself when you imagine you are not Shia and you want to find what is the truth. And you spend time researching and reading, and then you come to this conviction through rationality, not through emotions. Many of the Shias are Shia through emotions, atifa, not aql. Believe me, atifa. So we all, I address my speech to all Muslims. We have to study, we have to research. And Allah says, if you study, I will get you to the path. I will get you to the right path. وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَعَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَالْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ الْأَحْيَاءِ مِنْهُمْ وَالْأَمْوَاتِ. Tomorrow, Saturday, we have the Hajj, first Hajj class here at 4 to 6, inshallah. Those of you who are heading to Hajj this year, come to this class to learn Manasik al-Hajj, the rites of Hajj. And then at 7:30, inshallah, we begin the celebration of the Milad of the 8th Imam of Ahlul Bayt, Al-Imam Ali ibn Musa al-Ridha, alayhi salatu wassalam. We begin with 7:30 with Salatul Maghrib, inshallah. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minin wal mu'minat wal muslimin wal muslimat al-ahya'i minhum wal amwat. تابع اللهم بيننا وبينهم بالخيرات اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين على الخير والصلاح والبر والتقوى يا أرحم الراحمين من على مرضانا بالشفاء والعافية وعجل في فرج سيدنا ومولانا صاحب العصر والزمان وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات والشهداء ثواب الفاتحة مع الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد.